On my in the distance, I saw a Yodel delivery driver drop quite a lot of bits of square bits of paper and not even bother to pick them up. I thought, litter bug. And I watched them drive away, not caring. Turns out when I got closer, they're actually delivery notes with names, addresses, postcodes, phone numbers. This is a fraudster's dream, being dropped off by Yodel deliveries. Look, it's just a few of them I managed to catch before they all got blown off in the wind. Well, the one for Mr. Joyce has got a red cross on it. Probably because they will be quite cross when we give them a call. Let's give them a call. Right, you know, if you don't know about Yodel deliveries, I've had problems with myself in the past, and I've done a bit of research on them, and when I say I've done a bit of research, that means you don't have to do a lot of research to realise how bad this company are. I feel like I'm working for BBC Watchdog. Oh, hello, my name's Charlie. You've got to know who I am, but I know you are. Because Yodel Delivery have just like dropped a load of square bits of paper with your details on to fly down the Uxbridge Road, and the Yodel Delivery driver didn't care about it. So, you've got, I assume you've got a package which you've ordered through Yodel Delivery. Yeah? Pardon? Well, that's giving out my address, but I know your address. Uxbridge Road. I found them flying down the Uxbridge Road. In Hillingdon, London. Yeah. Yeah, I know you're in Surrey, yeah. I've got everything of yours. A name, address, phone number, alternative phone number. Oh, it's the same one as your home number, isn't it? Yodel's alternative delivery return address, which is Yodel, which is 50 Coxway in Chessington. I've got loads of people's numbers, and I'm actually doing a video on YouTube, so rest assured I'm not going to use your details to be malicious or anything. Alright, so I'll destroy all these details because there's nothing I can do with them. But I don't know if you're going to get your package or not. Yeah, it was Uxbridge Road in Hillingdon, London, Uxbridge. Because I've got yours and I've got about, I've got two other people's, but there's loads of others just floating down the street, but I didn't have time to pick them up because it's really windy. Yeah, no probs, bye. And he's going to get the police onto it. You see, there's a chance that these people might get irate and horrible with me, like it's my fault. But after having problems with Yodel myself in the past, and whatnot, and I know loads of people who have. Hello, my name's Charlie. I've just got off the phone to somebody else. You've got a package coming through Yodel Delivery? My address? Oh, well, I won't give up my address, but I know your address, because Yodel Delivery, there was, he just let a load of piece of papers fall out of his van. He didn't even bother to pick it. A Yodel Delivery driver dropped a load of piece of, lots of pieces of can you not hear me? Can you hear me? Yeah. the Yodel Delivery driver, I saw in the distance, dropped loads of pieces of paper. And he didn't bother to pick them up. And when I found a few of them, because I've just got off the phone to somebody else, it's actually names, addresses, phone numbers and everything, which is like data protection, really. And I just wanted to give you a call to let you know, I don't know what's happened to what you've ordered through Yodel Delivery, but I don't know if you're going to get it or not now, because Yodel don't seem to care if you get it or not. I know this is a strange phone call, because the only reason I'm calling you is because I've had problems with Yodel before, and the customer service is appalling, and they've been on Watchdog and everything. And I thought, well, instead of just like putting these in the bin, I thought I'd give the people a call so you could call Yodel yourself and tell them that they're just throwing your address and your details around and they don't care. I've got your name and address, and before I go any further, I'm actually recording this on YouTube. I'm not giving out your details, you don't have to worry, you'll see all that on the video. I'm going to destroy these properly, like they should be doing. But I've got your name, address, phone number, alternative phone number, which is the same as your home number, and your full details, really. I know you live in Surrey. I'm actually in Uxbridge, Hillingdon. If you want to contact Yodel, do you want me to give them the distribution address so you know which number to call? Yeah. Right. The Yodel alternative address is Yodel 50 Cox Lane in Chessington. Parcel numbers as well. Yeah, I suppose that's the number under the big barcode. That'll be your parcel number, yeah. But, I mean, anyone could have got hold of this, but rest assured, I'm not some... Do you know what I mean? You're really fortunate I've got yours, and hopefully no one's going to get hold of the rest of your details because they were just flying down the street. Well... Yeah, it was doing a delivery. I saw him in the distance, and they all fell off the box, top of the box, and he just looked at them blow away. And by the time I got there, it drove off, and I saw one of them on the floor, and it was someone's address, not yours. And then I found loads of others, so it wasn't like a one-off. It was just like falling off the top of the box. So I just wanted to let you know. So you know, it's the Chessington 50 Cox Lane. Address. So when you call Yodel, you can give him a piece of your mind, I suppose. But, okay then, hon. I'm just about to call my last one now, so I'll let you go.
Okay, bye.
Alright, bye. Well, she was nice as well. This is a landline number. I've dialed an incorrect number. This is a made up number. It's just 01234567 8. So, I had two for the same person, didn't I? Yes, so the Mr. Goals, in his wisdom, has given out a fake phone number, or just not given a number. Well, that's my bit for Watchdog, even though I don't even work for Watchdog. But we've had one person seen is going to call the police, and I've told the other lady to give him a piece of the mind. So, Yodel Delivery. Right, so that's everyone I could call, and... That's everything, really. It's quite ironic, actually, that it's at Yodel on Cox Lane. Irony! So that's one person going to call the police, and one person going to give them a piece of their mind. Right, I've torn all this up, and what I do is, with all my addresses and stuff, is I put them in an old milk bottle, which is half full of water, post it in, shake it all up so it's just mush, and that's how I take care of my details. But what is the point of doing that when you've got companies just throwing details down the street? Well, thanks for watching. Please comment, rate and subscribe, because the more people who watch this, the better it is for me. So that was some much delayed payback to Yodel, which was great. Finally, karma took a long time coming around, so I had to give it a helping hand. Ah well, thanks for watching, bye. What I actually found was like square bits of paper with people's names, addresses, parcel numbers, phone numbers, well, the details really. No, it's not A4, no. Well, I've already ripped them up now, you know. I've disposed of them now, but they weren't A4 at all. It was like square bits of paper, like no bigger than a square of, like, oh, I don't know, toilet roll. No, not a calling card, no. But they did have, like, a staple. They'd been at one point stapled together, because there was a staple mark from the middle of them.
Well, I don't know. I assume so. Yeah, I mean, all the details was on there. I mean, what I saw happen was in the distance, I saw one of your Yodel delivery vans, you know, the green, so not easy to miss. And then, pardon? Yeah, and in the distance, I saw, like, there must have been about 10 pieces of paper blow off and down the street, and he looked at them and thought, litter bug, because, you know what I mean? And then, but when I got closer, I saw it had an address on it, and I picked it up, and I picked up three others. I got four altogether, but there was some more just like floating around, but it was too windy to pick them up. But you could have easily picked them up, because the ones I picked up hadn't even blown anywhere. It made no attempts to pick them up at all. Oh, definitely away, because he looked at them. He looked at them. That's what I mean, because that's why I thought, first of all, litterbug when I was walking up the street. And then, it was only when I got closer that I realised, because I work in retail, I know that sometimes you get the sticky, I thought there might have been like the sticky back bits. Do you know what you mean, you know, when you stick them on the box? I thought it might just let them blow away, I thought that's what there was. It was only when I got closer I realised that it was names, addresses, phone numbers, postcodes, item delivery numbers, all on this piece of paper. And then... Oh, I had everything on there. I mean, the people that I did find, I'm really fortunate that it was me who found them, because that stuff's data protection and a fraudster's nightmare. I've already destroyed them now. I mean, what I've torn them into tiny, tiny pieces. But I could give them back to you, I suppose. I could post them to you if you want. Oh no, it was far too much in the distance. But about an hour and 2 hours ago now. But I mean, I've torn them all up into tiny pieces. So what I'll do is, actually, I can still make out some of the names. Actually, you can have to piece them back together. But I suppose I could post them back to you if you want.